Welcome to another live stream tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and add overlays to your Xbox utilizing Livestream Studio to be able to make your stream look professional. Let's go ahead and dive in. Now, there's going to be three things that you're going to be able to need to be able to follow along. The first is going to be a computer, and you're only going to need access to the computer for the initial setup. Later in the video, I'm going to show you a quick hack on how you can utilize your mobile to be able to manage all your scenes and things of that sort. The second thing you're going to need is going to be a Livestream Studio subscription. Now, Livestream is now free. They have plans, as you can see, that range anywhere between $8, $12, or $16 a month based on the resolution that you select. And by utilizing the link in the description, you're going to be able to get a 7-day free trial plus 25% off your first month. Now, if you want a free option, you can utilize a tool called Overlay Expert. Now, I'm not a big fan of it simply because your viewers can't see your overlays on your mobile. They can't see your overlays on your VODs, and it's a little bit more complex to be able to get set up. Now, the third thing that you're going to need, of course, is the most important. It's going to be your overlays that you're going to set up on your Xbox. Now, I wanted to make this as easy as possible for you, so if you don't have overlays, I'm going to make the package that I'm utilizing today completely free to you. So you can go to the description of the video, go to streamdesigns.com, and you'll be able to get the package by entering the coupon code at checkout called Free Xbox Overlays, and you'll get the package completely for free. So once you're going to head and set up your account, you're going to be able to be in this dashboard that you see here. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to go ahead and connect your Twitch account. So on the right hand side, you want to come to where it says destination settings, and you want to go ahead and click add destination, and you want to go ahead and add Twitch. Once you click that, it's going to go ahead and ask you to authorize Livestream to have access to your Twitch account. So you'll do that. And then once you've gone ahead and linked your Twitch account, the very next thing you want to do, and this is very important, is on the left hand side, you want to come to where it says gamer project, and you want to make sure that auto live project is toggled on. This is so important because what this means is that after we set this up the first time, you don't need to open up Livestream on your computer again. It's automatically going to put your overlays on your stream when you go live on Twitch on your Xbox. So make sure that's selected there. All right, so now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and add your overlays. So the first thing you want to do on the left hand side where it says layers, you want to click the plus sign. You want to click image, and then you want to go ahead and upload an image and access your overlays or the overlay package that I went ahead and provided for you. So we'll go ahead and add our starting soon screen, and you'll see that it'll populate here. The next thing we want to do is you want to go ahead and add a countdown timer. So to do that, we want to go ahead and go to the plus sign, third party integrations. You want to select browser source, and then it's going to ask you to go ahead and enter a URL. You want to go ahead and pause the video, and you want to go to the description of the video, and you want to go to where it says lastcurry.com countdown timer tool. I created a free tool that you can go ahead and utilize to be able to have a countdown timer. So you want you here, you can select start minutes. You can put 5, 10 minutes, however long you want, and then font color, I'm going to go ahead and type in black, and then I'm going to go ahead and hit get my timer. Now what this is going to do is going to open up a new window with the timer, and we want to go ahead and copy the URL at the top. Then you want to come back to Livestream, you want to click on the browser source, and you want to paste the URL there. It's then going to go ahead and populate the countdown timer directly here, and then you can position it where you like. And now our countdown timer is set up. Next, we want to go ahead and add our alerts, right? So that our viewers get notified when we see things happen and action taken. So you want to click this plus sign, you want to click third party integrations, and you want to go where it says rainmaker.gg. Now you want to select open Rainmaker, and this is going to bring you to the editor where we're going to be able to go ahead and make the alerts. So on the left hand side, you want to click where it says overlay, you want to select new overlay, you want to go ahead and type in alerts, and then you want to go ahead and select create overlay. It's going to open up the editor. So now what we want to do is on the left hand side, you want to select the plus sign, you want to come to where it says alerts, and you'll see that Rainmaker is going to give you an alert overlay that you can utilize. You can utilize your own, or you can utilize the ones that I provided for you. So the first thing we want to do on the left hand side, if you're utilizing the package that I have provided for you, you want to uncheck the things that you don't have access to. So charity donation, tweet, you know, community gift, subscription gift, resubscription, and then a raid. Everything else you can keep. So the way to be able to change these overlays is you want to click on the follow, you want to scroll down to where it says replace, And then you want to go ahead and add the alert that I went ahead and provided for you. Then you'll see it pop up here. And now what we want to do is you want to go ahead and customize this text so that it looks good. First thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and center align it. Then you want to come to this image here. And if you're utilizing Maya overlays, you're going to want to type in 91 there. And then you're going to want to type in 73. And that's going to go ahead and center it. Now, I like to go ahead and have people's picture pop up. Just another way to be able to demonstrate your appreciation for that person. So once you've done that, you have your overlay set up. And you can go ahead and come back to settings and do the same for each individual one that we just did. Now that we have our overlay set up, what we want to do is we want to go ahead and exit. We want to come here and we want to click this link here. Now we want to come back to Livestream and we want to paste that link directly into Livestream. You're going to see that it's going to go ahead and be loaded. So what you want to do is you want to come back to Rainmaker, you want to hit test, you want to hit follow, and you're going to see here that it pops up. And now you can place this wherever it is that you like. And now that alert, it's going to go ahead and pop up. Now, I personally like to also add the chat to my starting soon just to be able to start seeing the engagement. So to be able to do that, what we want to do is we want to come back. We want to go ahead and add new overlay. We want to go ahead and type in chat. And then you want to head select create overlay. You'll open it up. You'll come to the left-hand side, hit the plus icon. You'll hit chat. And then what I like to do is I like to put the chat on the bottom left-hand side, and you can go ahead and customize it. I like to have it a little bit longer and then put it on the corner. And then what you want to do is you want to go back. You want to copy this link here. You want to go to Livestream, and we want to go ahead and add the plus sign, right? We're then going to go ahead and go to third-party integration. We're going to select Rainmaker GG. You're going to go ahead and paste it there. Hit enter. And now you're going to see that that overlay is going to go ahead and pop up and the chat would be here. Now you're not going to be able to test the chat beforehand, but once you go live, you can start commenting or do a test stream to be able to see the chat appear there. Now our starting soon screen is done. So what we want to do is you want to come to the bottom and you want to hit duplicate. You're then going to see that it's going to populate a second screen. And then what we want to do is you simply just want to go ahead and remove the countdown timer and the starting soon. We're going to leave our chat and we're going to leave our alerts. So you want to hit the plus sign. You're then going to go ahead and go hit image. And in the description of this video, I went ahead and gave you access to this image here. Since you can only go live to be able to see the placement of your camera, this image here lets you know all the positions you're going to be able to put your camera on your Xbox. So once you have that there, you're going to go ahead and hit the plus sign again. You're going to hit image. And now we're going to go ahead and either upload your webcam overlay or utilize the one I provided. And then we'll have it, we'll add it. And then we'll select where we're gonna want our camera to be. Now I'm gonna go ahead and utilize the middle. So we'll size this up, put it, position it there, make sure that it's nice and snug. And then once it's there, what you wanna do is you wanna go ahead and delete the image that we have there. Now we have our webcam added. Now we wanna make sure that we add our gameplay. So you wanna click this plus sign. You then want to select the game source, and now you're going to see that your game is going to be visible there. Once again, you can come back to Rainmaker, you can come to your alerts, you can select on test, select follow, and you can see here that also now you have your alerts there. Now your chat is going to be here on the bottom side, so if you want to, you can move it over to the right side, that way it's now more balanced, and now you have your chat, your face cam overlay, and your alerts set up on that screen there. So the next thing that I want to do is I want to duplicate the first scene again. That's going to give me a new scene. And what I want to do is I want to go ahead and delete the starting soon. Everything else is going to remain because we're going to make a Be Right Back scene. So what you want to do is you want to hit this plus sign. You want to come to image. You want to go ahead and select Be Right Back. And you're going to see that it's going to populate. Now, what we want to do is we want to go ahead and move everything above the Be Right Back screen. So drag it, put everything on top. And then once you have it on top, you'll start to see everything populate. So you'll see your timer, you'll see the Be Right Back screen, you'll see your alerts, and you'll see your chat be present there as well. So now we went ahead and created your Be Right Back screen. And the last screen that we want to go ahead and add is gonna be your stream ending. So you wanna hit the plus sign, you wanna go ahead and hit this icon, hit image, and then we wanna go ahead and hit stream ending soon. And now you're gonna go ahead and have those set up there. Now what we wanna do is we wanna go ahead and go into Twitch to be able to finish this process. So now that you have all these scenes set up, we're going to go ahead and go to Twitch. So to be able to do that, go to your Xbox and select Twitch. All right, so once you go ahead and have Twitch open, you're going to want to come to where it says broadcast. You're then going to want to select destination, and you're going to want to make sure this says live stream. This lets live stream know that you're integrating with them to allow them to put overlays on your Twitch stream. Then once you've gone ahead and done that, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and select start streaming. And once you go ahead and see next to the start streaming button, your link with your username pop up that lets you know that you are now live. So what we want to do is you want to come back to live stream, and you want to see here that it says that you are live. You'll see on the right hand side, it's going to show you a preview as well as your chat. So you're able to manage everything here, but I promise you that I'll show you a little hack and how you can manage everything on your phone. So what you want to do is you want to go to your mobile device, and you want to go ahead and go to remote.goatlivestream.com. I put the link in the description of this video. And then once you're there, you're going to see a window just like this. And what that's going to allow you to be able to do is that you're going to go ahead and see all of your scenes listed there, and then you're able to switch between them. So you see here that they have the gameplay screen. You're going to see here I have my ending soon scene, and then you're going to see that I have the new scene. Now I want to go ahead and add my gameplay. So when I come here to my Xbox, I'll back out. I'll load up a game, and then what I want to do is I want to show you what this looks like directly on Twitch. So we'll come back to Twitch, and you'll see here that right now I have my Be Right Back screen open. So directly on my mobile device, I can go ahead and select the gameplay. So you'll see it there. It'll automatically go ahead and switch to the gameplay scene on my Xbox. It'll then go ahead and switch over to my ending soon screen, and it just takes a few seconds for it to happen. And then you'll see I can go back to a different scene, and just like that, you can see how I'm able to manage everything directly on my mobile. Now if you want to go ahead and add animated overlays instead of static overlays, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to set up animated overlays directly inside of Livestream Studio. I'll see you in the next video.